أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قامت صلاة قامت صلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
Research would dictate that the university experience has a secularising impact on students of faith. It is clear that faith is one of the many aspects of university students' lives that has taken a step back from activism. At the University of Kent, more than half a dozen faiths and denominations exist and thrive. Alongside these, dozens of religious societies embrace students across the campuses every year. On our journey, we have encountered students who have the courage to believe in something, to express certainty in a time of passivity and doubt.
Identified sort of primarily as atheist, but just open to anything that comes around. Most people here on campus are basically non-religious, so I've not really felt any kind of problem whatsoever for being non-religious here. It's important to understand sort of what people believe, what they think, what makes them tick, as they say. And if you don't sort of learn this stuff, you are missing out part of the picture.
Or maybe it's not reachable because of the limitation of our senses, or as a human being, or the physics of our world and what we can...
We had an open day at the Canterbury Mosque, which had an attendance of approximately 500 visitors, and including those visitors was Britain First, and they came to demonstrate outside our mosque. Basically their belief was that we're building a mega mosque, and that was an incorrect belief, and that's when Nick got involved. He heard about Britain First coming down and he decided he wanted to do something about it.
My name's Hanifa. I'm a first year at University of Kent, and I'm a Muslim. As Shakespeare said, to thine own self be true. I want to be true to myself, and I think university has really let me do that, you know, be true to myself, wear what I want to wear, you know, express myself how I want to.
You can say that you are not Jewish, you can eat pork, you can not do the laws of Judaism, you can wear a cross, go to a church, do whatever you want, but you will always be seen as a Jew in the eye of the world. This fact that I was stigmatized as a Jew, even though I didn't want it to be stigmatized, I wanted to be my choice. It gives me strength to be a Jew, and it gives me motivation to be even more Jewish and to say that, yes, I am Jewish, and this is my perception of what being Jewish means. So I wear a Star of David, a Magen David, as we say it in Hebrew.
Yeah, coming here has been massive. I don't think I've grown in my faith as much as I have just since I've been here. The Lord has like really wrecked me over a lot of things, like in the best way possible. I've learned so much. I've like gotten to know myself. I know the Lord more now. I see a different perspective on Christianity from people who don't have the same kind of church life that I do. I think as you grow up, as you mature, as you dive deeper into your faith, as you learn more about God, about yourself, like your prayer just gets different. Prayer doesn't really ever stay the same. Like, my prayer life is always changing. It goes in waves up and down, between really intimate or maybe I'll like distance a little bit on accident. Like, I just pull back.
The reason with turbans and the beards and stuff is for identity. So if you see me in a crowd, then you should be able to spot me. Sometimes I do wear different colors. When you see a Sikh, you should feel a sense of protection and you should feel a sense of safety, as in if you have a problem, then a Sikh will be at your service.
My family moved to Canada at the same time as I went to university, so whilst everyone kind of experiences that location from their family, mine felt rather more emphasised. There's no kind of shelter for you to be under of, oh yeah, my parents say this. It's kind of, if you're interested, you then, you take those steps into looking at theology, looking at your faith and questioning it, understanding what you believe. So it's become my own at university.
I'm definitely not an atheist. I definitely believe there is like a God in this world. Like, you know, Paley's watch theory, where if you see a watch on the beach, you don't think it's a natural product of the world. You know, it's made by something. I have that same sort of view, so I think this is made by Allah and so on. However, I just naturally lazy when it comes to my duties. Instead, I just follow more my morals to be a good person instead, such as giving to charity, because I can't. I feel like the only way to truly understand a religion is just to practice it yourself. Like, being a Muslim, you have to be quite dedicated, praying 5 times a day, something my grandparents do. They wake up at like 2, wake up at 5 a.m., pray, sleep, wake up at 10, pray, sleep, do Maghrib, pray, sleep. It's quite a dedication.
The whole thing of Britain First is that when they give an opinion, they generally don't want people to speak out against it. And in this particular case, it was clear that a lot of students felt very strongly about having a very strong section of faith at the university. I thought it would be apt for us to come together and demonstrate that we stood with everyone.
What was involved in starting the march going?
Literally social media. I posted an event on Facebook, invited all my friends, started messaging all different circles of people I knew, and slowly, surely, Shuri sort of all came together. Everyone came with lots of placards and all that sort of stuff, and yeah, we just went.
When Britain First turned up at the mosque, I was actually inside, and it was prayer time. It was the late afternoon prayer, and I got a knock on the window, and one of my volunteers says to me that there's a march going on outside. During the time they were there, they were trying to ask us intimidating questions, and we made sure that our volunteers didn't answer any.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. La.
Obviously, you know, clubbing, drinking, and all this is out of the question, but that's not everything that a student should do as a part of their social life. For example, like, the ISOC girls and I, we went laser tagging, you know, we go out for meals, we, you know, there's so many social things that we can do that, normal.
Because I'm a part of the Hindu Sock committee, we organise so many events. So not too long ago, we set up a ball, a Diwali ball, and that was brilliant. It was definitely like provided a really good atmosphere for like just for the students to sort of feel like, oh, I'm actually celebrating my festival at uni. I get to celebrate it with my uni friends, not just at home with my family and family friends. I don't think there is somewhere that's like accommodates for Hindus besides this society, because there isn't that one place that we can go and pray. It kind of doesn't allow us to practice our religion in that way, which is why it's so good that we've got the society set up for people who do want to have that opportunity.
What's your name?
Manvi. So Manvi for my show. Yes, if you see what you can do, you can take some home as well, if you want. Or a friend, if you want.
Okay.
Yeah, sure, no problem. Yeah, you know.
I just be president of a Sikh society. It is quite a lot of work as well, because you have to obviously like come up with ways of socializing as well. Because we believe in the concept of God being everywhere, we don't really have certain restrictions of when we can pray, when we can't pray. In terms of Sikh, you should be thinking of God every day anyway. So we always think of God whenever we are and wherever we are. So that doesn't really change. But in terms of Sikh, the conservative Sikh community here, which I do know, there isn't much, to be fair, in Canterbury. Because I think Canterbury is one town which actually doesn't have a Sikh temple. So that's one of the things that I actually did find a bit okay, what's going on here. That's going to be quite hard for the Sikh society as well, because obviously a Sikh temple is a place of worship, it's a place of protection, it's a place of where you can go and you can obviously meditate and learn about God as well. So for it not being here, it was quite hard to like, involve people in the concept of God in that sense. But we still do manage it, and it's actually quite good, because that's the main thing about being in the company of Satsangud, so being in the company of people. So once you're in that company, then you learn about Sikhism, then you also connect as well. So we're still pretty much the same to us, you know, in that sense. So with Langud, the idea is to we sit down on the floor, equality. So as in, no one's higher than anyone, we're all the same. And then what we do, we eat together and we serve together. So that's the idea of seeing God through everyone's eyes in that sense there.
We didn't actually expect that much of a number to come inside the mosque, but we couldn't actually fit everyone in. People enjoyed it. They, a lot of people, that was their first time seeing a mosque inside, and they didn't actually realise that place was a mosque. And thanks to Nick and Britain First, obviously, a lot of people found out it was a mosque. Comes through the earth, he will rule the world with justice, and the peoples with fairness.
The Lord comes to rule the peoples with fairness.
I was raised a Protestant and became Catholic nearly 3 years ago at uni. I felt that the churches that I went to while I was growing up, they had kind of lost something there was a kind of a gap between the Bible, which my parents had got me to read a lot and to love, and all the churches that I went to. And so I started questioning them, and I stopped going to Protestant churches, and then eventually I came across Catholicism and went to Catholic Church, and I found suddenly that everything kind of agreed and that it made sense. No, I wouldn't say that there's any judgment or lack of acceptance. It just, I think it makes you a bit different. And here I've got the Catholic Society, and so I can pray with them and discuss things with them. It's easier when you're doing things with your friends. It's growing more meaningful to me as I've gone on.
The biggest thing I got was, I'm so happy someone's organised this, I'm so happy this is going ahead. And just people telling me how proud they were that everyone was coming together to do it. Those of us who are non-Muslim especially, we can't be passive anymore. When people voice an opinion that you believe is bigoted, racist, whatever, you need to take a stand against that. I think that was the biggest thing to come out of that event, is that all of us students came together and we made such a clear and defiant message. And I think really students should be doing that a lot more, and I hope they do in the future.
Like Islamophobia, basically. It's really affected us. Well, it's affected me, because obviously I'm a Muslim growing up in the Western world, and not many people understand our customs, or, you know, they don't understand the religion. They just think they can take one little bit of the Holy Quran and they can just, like, you know, explode it into something just so wrong. So they take one line and they have no context behind it, but then they can just say, oh, Islam is a religion of violence, and it's just, it's not cool.
Personally, I think it's best to not tell people your religion or talk about it if you're like very devout. That way you avoid confrontations.
I think being private with your faith, at least as a Christian, I can't speak to other faiths, is wrong because you're called to go out and disciple, or at least demonstrate faith, demonstrate life in Christ. But there are points where you talk to someone and they're like, look, mate, I don't really want to know anymore, just want to talk. And that's fine. It's kind of, and it's just being a part of their lives.
Anti-Semitism is a sort of racism. Racism comes from the fear of the unknown and the fear of something being different. This is xenophobia, anti-Semitism, it's all sorts of racism and discrimination. I believe that in university there is not a real anti-Semitism. I never personally been abused. I felt threatened. Last year there was a debate about BDS, it's boycott, divestment, sanction, which bases itself on the fact that, the alleged fact that Israel doesn't recognize the human rights of the Palestinian people. This thing got out of hand really, really a lot. And when we talk about anti-Semitism or anti-Zionism, some people mix up the two and it's a new form of anti-Semitism or anti-Judaism or Judeophobia.
When you're at university, you become a lot more understanding. You see the wider world around you, so you encounter a lot of different ideas, and so when you unpack your own and someone unpacks theirs, you kind of think they might merge, you might take things from there, you might be more secure in your own. You have your faith, which to me is, it's how I live my life. It's a relationship with someone very real. So I find my faith in that. I find it in the everyday, in praying, in living the life that I'm called to.
If we took time to understand everyone's religion, we can find that there are so many similarities between them that we wouldn't feel the need to judge them. So I really support those people who are trying to broaden their knowledge on different religions.
So the march ended here. This is where everyone congregated at the end, and that's when they all invited them back to the mosque for their mini open day, as it were. Students need to make sure that they always get their voices heard. My one criticism of life here at uni is people don't protest enough, people don't demonstrate enough. And what I hope is that our demonstration may spur other people on to take action when they see wrongs being committed.
It showed us as the Muslim community in Canterbury and in the University of Kent that there are people who will stand by us no matter how many people want to go against us. The students, they value other religions, they respect other religions. By blocking speakers from coming down to the university, you're not only preventing others from learning about other people's religions, but you're pushing away other religious societies from yourselves because they feel like you're not helping them.
Because of five members who are, we call uneducated, we've got hundreds here today, so we want to thank them for giving us extra support. Because of them, you lot wouldn't have been here.
Wow, the amount of people that come here is just incredible and extremely heartwarming, and I never imagined so many people would turn up. And I think today the message we need to give out is, we may be people from different countries, different cultures, different faiths, but the point is, we can agree to disagree, and we don't, and that disagreement does not lead to bigotry or racism. Thank you very much.
Fasting. We as Muslims, we have to fast for the month of Ramadan. It's the ninth month of the Muslim calendar. We fast for the whole month. The fasting is to do with daylight and sunset. We fast at the moment, we start our fast at 2:30 in the morning, and we finish about 9:20. So we don't drink, we don't smoke, we don't eat anything, and we don't get engaged in anything that is pleasurable. We spend our day praying, reading the Quran, and send our blessing, and do praise God throughout the day. And all our activities is revolve around this. We also provide food at the mosque. We've been doing that for the last 15 years, since we bought this place. And at the beginning, when the students were here, we were providing food for about 120 people. Apart from fasting, we also raise money for charity. We break fast with dates and water, and we pray for 5 minutes, and then we serve the food afterwards. Now you will hear a call of prayer in about 5 minutes. It's the most famous word you will hear, Allahu Akbar. Unfortunately, a lot of time it is used in the wrong place at the wrong time for the wrong reason. Allahu Akbar means Allah is great. We cannot do something wrong in the name of God.
الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين.
The other thing I forgot to say, this the student union worked with us together as one big organization, and over the last 3 years, thanks to the activities and the enthusiasm of the students, we have a greater participation both at the university and in our community.
Students are passionate about their communities, their societies, their personal journeys. But beyond that, we may have only dipped our toes in the reality of religion on campus, but we have encountered faith, trust, love, and pure joy.